and they are grown. Ne? Now you change. You are not worshiping now.
Why are you making decisions? Why are you not?
Now you are making noise, but you are saying I'm coming from worshiping. And he just said, she just said, ne? Just rest. Do your own dishes. Do your own dishes. Never shout with them anymore because they are your own. I am the one who wants to see clean. They don't understand, they will see it, I'm just do it. Mm. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Then worship goes on.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And just saying this, I do not mean that kids leave dishes. Ne? I don't mean leave the house dirty. It is all our responsibility. A house is a place where we love to sit. Ne? And all of us, we have a part to play. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
We thank Jesus. We have a soul. Jesus. In this place it goes on and 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 on. Hallelujah. Jesus, you are wonderful.
We welcome you. We welcome you. Father, we welcome you. We welcome you.
Are we healed?
We are healed.
Are we blessed?
We are blessed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we redeemed?
We are redeemed.
Are we redeemed?
We are redeemed.
Are we saved?
We are saved.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Clap those hands for Jesus. Just clap those hands for Jesus. Clap the hands for Jesus. Clap the hands for Jesus.
Glory, 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 glory.
Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Do you love Jesus?
I love Jesus.
Do you love Jesus?
I love Jesus.
Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Say it from the heart. Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you.
Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Do you love your Father?
I love my Father.
Say, I love you, Father.
I love you, Father.
Say, I love you, Father.
I love you, Father.
Say, I love you.
I love you.
Say, mwah, 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 I love you. Say, mwah, 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 I love you. Praise God.
Amen.
You are all welcome in the presence of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are all welcome in the presence of God. Amen.
Amen.
Because I am the presence of God and you are the presence of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are where God lives. Amen.
Amen.
You are the temple of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God lives in no way but in you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
God says, I'm going to the Father to prepare the house, the place for you. When I am ready, I come. He comes, the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
There's one thing for sure, that the world is different from God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
When the world says, I'm leaving you, it's something like I'm moving away from something that I was with. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when God says, I'm leaving you, he's coming in you. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Just clap for Jesus as he's in you. In you.
No one can be against
you. Nothing can be against you.
Hallelujah.
Because God himself is living in you.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
I know that you are learning about your situation. I know that you are learning about the sons. Just say to your neighbor, how are you the son of God?
How are you the son of God?
Say, how are you the son of God?
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 Tell the neighbor, say, I am the son of God. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Are you?
I am.
I am the Son of God. Are you?
I am.
Hallelujah.
I am.
Are you?
I am.
Are you sure?
I am.
Show your excitement.
I am.
Are you? Amen. He changed the pain in me.
Amen.
And then he made me righteous.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If God can change me, you are nothing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If God can change me, your neighbor is nothing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If God can change Paul, a state persecutor, I am nothing. You are nothing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do we love Jesus?
I love Jesus.
Do we really love Jesus?
I love Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I love Jesus.
Amen.
And I love you. Because you are Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I love you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you are the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Because you are the Son of God. You know, when the Master, when the king has a prince, the prince is exactly as this, as a master. Am I right?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The prince is exactly as the master. If a prince come out and say, I'm going to kill you, it's the same as the master is saying. Am I right?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus. Whatever the prince says is the same as the master says. Amen. It's no longer I who speak that you see, but the Christ who is in me. Praise Master Jesus. Say a plus to you. It's no longer you who is sitting there, but it's the Christ. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God wanted to praise himself so much. God Almighty. He wanted to praise himself so much. He wanted to love himself so much. Amen. Hallelujah. God himself wanted to love himself so much. Amen.
Amen.
And he created you. Amen.
Amen.
And he put his spirit in you so that he can praise himself through you. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
Are we one? So that he can praise himself through you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not you who's praising God. You think it's you? It's Christ himself praising himself in you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. That's why there's no reason for you to worry about. That's why there's no reason for you to complain about. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. I just want to talk about your situation just now. The situations, our situations. Our situations sometimes, when they come, we don't know why they are coming. I might find myself maybe in darkness. Why God has allowed this situation to happen to me? Praise God.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are a predestined. You are a predestined. Amen.
Amen.
You are living a history to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are living a history to God. God already have your records with him. You are like playing a movie and God is a producer of that movie. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus. Wherever you go, it has been written that you will go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are that steering in that movie. And the steering will never die. And the steering will never fail. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. When you watch a movie and you know about the steering, you sure whether they beat him, whether they destroy him, you sure that this steering will live forever until the movie ends. Am I right? Am I right? And then you are that steering in the movie of God. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That situation that you were in or that you are in or that you will encounter in future, it has been written for you to pass through, because God trusted you so much that you will go through that situation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will pass that situation in flying colors. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For example, if you have a bomb, you create a bomb. If you create a bomb or a gun, a strong bomb, and you develop this bomb, and say this bomb is strong, this bomb can destroy anything, where will you test it? Do you take it to the ground and test it to the ground? Or do you take it to the rock, strong rock in the mountain to test it? I will take it to the mountain, to the strong rocks, to test the bomb, if you can blow the mountain. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. And I am that bomb that the Master created. And you are that bomb that God has created. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. Stop complaining about something that you've subdued already. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Stop complaining about something that you know that I will pass. Christians, are we the Christians? Are we the Christians here? Yeah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Are we the Christians here? Yeah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. If you are not a Christian and you are ready to be a Christian, say, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, come into my heart, come into my heart, be my Lord and Savior, heal me, heal me, redeem me, save me, wash me with your precious blood today. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Are we together? So now I'm speaking to the Christians. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. I'm speaking to the citizens of heaven. Amen. You're not going to complain about a situation that you know that God already has passed over. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Every situation, every complaint, every particles, every steps, they lead to death. Am I right? Every problem, losing a job, it leads to death. Am I right? Hallelujah. You might complain, you have a heart attack and you die. Praise Master Jesus. Your neighbor is talking bad about you. You might complain, you have a heart attack, or maybe you might take your gun and shoot one another. Hallelujah. Every situation leads to death. But death is not our enemy anymore. Death is our servant. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. God Almighty, your master, overcome death. Amen. So I overcome death. He overcome death for me, not for himself. Do you think that Jesus, when he goes to the cross, he wanted maybe the whole world to say, you know, he's a hero, he's a great. No. He went for me and you. Amen. He went for me and you, not for himself. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. So your master overcome death. So why you worry about the sickness? If your master overcome death, what is sickness comparing to death? In the world, death is greater. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. Why you worry about poverty? Because you think that when you're poor, you will not have food to eat and you starve to death. Everything leads to death. But your master overcome death. And I overcome death. Because I'm dead already. Are you dead? Are you dead to this world? Are you still alive to this world?
No.
Hallelujah. So we Christians, we are dead to this earth. Hallelujah. That's why we are not moved by fashion, clothing, house, cars, money. Hallelujah. We are not moved. They don't shake us. We shake them. Hallelujah. We are not gathered here to receive money. We are not gathered here to receive houses. We are not gathered here to receive cars. If that is in your mind, it's a wrong place. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. If that is in your mind, you are in a wrong place. Go and gamble, maybe you'll get money. Hallelujah. Amen. This is a place where we worship God. We are in the kingdom of God. We don't worry about the cars, because the cars, they are part of the kingdom. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. When you enter the house of the king, you know that when the king say welcome you, you will roll like that woman we saw here rolling down. Because you know that in the kingdom of God, in the kingdom of the king, there is food. There's everything. There's security. Whatever you will need, as you are invited in the king's house, you will receive. Am I right? You don't worry that I don't have 10 rent. You don't worry that what will I take out from the kingdom's house? Hallelujah. You are excited to be the part of the kingdom. Amen. That's the main thing. Part of the kingdom. Amen. So when we are part of the kingdom, God says what? He says, don't worry about what we shall eat, the Christians. Citizens, don't worry what you shall wear. Don't complain. Don't be fussy about it. Don't be fussy about those things. Instead of maybe going to the shop and checking the worrying about the clothes, the new fashion and the rest. He said, go out to the mountain and see the flowers, how they are dressed so beautiful. Even that no one can see them, but the Master God, He created them. How much more about you when you are in the kingdom of God? How much more can you do? Hallelujah. And by that time, you know, when your king, when your father is a king, even though you can spend 5 days without eating, do you worry? You don't, because you know that there are so many fridges, it's full. Hallelujah. When you are the son of the king, you don't worry that today I'm walking without shoes. You know that there are so many cars, there's so many everything, transport that can take you anywhere. Hallelujah. Amen. And Jesus is that king. And you know what? This Bible was not just written by someone who was bored. Amen. Everything about this is true. It's life. Science can say whatever they want to say. Hallelujah. Because science came after God. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Praise God. We don't have any other version of the Bible because we have one that's from God. Hallelujah. But science, we have new version, discovery, everything that comes every time. They say, oh no, we made a mistake here. Okay, now we see the new sun. Or now we see the new planet. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. But this never contradicts itself because it's from the heart of God. Hallelujah. And everything that is written here is not a mint. It's not a mistake. It's not something that was just written because someone was just, let me just write something. It's from the heart of God. And God says every word that He said, not even, this one is just, this Bible is just a drop in an ocean. Hallelujah. That's why when you read a verse, you find that there's so many explanations God is telling you. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Are we free? Are we free? You know, our situation, it matters how we react to our situation. Hallelujah. It matters how we react to our situation. Because sometimes when we react to our situation, it tells us that we will be the master of the situation or we will be the servants of the situation. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. So let me give you an example. When Jesus was searching and looking for the disciples, let's say that day Peter, because in Galilee they used to fish at night, because during the day it's daylight, the water is clean. They only fish at night. Hallelujah. Praise Mother Jesus. You cannot catch fish when the water is so clean. So when it is dark, the fish don't know where they're going. Then it's easy for you to catch the fish. Hallelujah. Praise Mother Jesus. Amen. So that day, Peter and them, they wake up. Maybe 12 o'clock midnight, said, guys, let's go for fishing. They were so happy, excited. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. They were happy going for fishing. Amen. When they went and then tried everything the whole night, they couldn't catch anything. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When the master was working, you find Peter ready mending the nets. Am I right? God says that. Holy Spirit says that. Am I right? When the master was just arriving at the seashore, Peter and them, they were mending their nets. For what? To go home. Am I right? Amen. Amen. Let's reverse. Let's say Peter, by 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, he caught some fish. Would the master meet him at that time when the master went to the seashore? He would have been gone. Hallelujah. He will be gone. Somebody will be found there. Amen. Peter might not be the apostle that we know today. Hallelujah. The situation that the lacking of Peter not catching some fish, it preserved for a better situation of the master. Am I right? Lacking, when he was crying, he said, I haven't caught anything. And then how about my wife and my children? They will suffer, they will die. Hallelujah. He was complaining. But when the master came, when the master come, the same situation of lack preserve for a good situation. Am I right? Praise Master Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. What if a prayer for a good position or situation was answered in your life? Where will you be today? Where will you be today? Maybe today you will be an agent of Satan. Am I right? What if a prayer of a good job, a good situation were answered? You wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be here. Tell you the truth, I wouldn't be here. If my prayer for long years was answered for a better life that I wanted that time, I wouldn't be standing here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I think the same applies to all of us. So what am I saying? I'm saying that don't worry about the situation, because God, sometimes He uses that situation to preserve you for a better life. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. What should you do when you are in that situation? Yes, I don't have money. I have nothing. I see. And then, do you think that God doesn't know that you don't have money? God is omnipresent, omnipotent, everywhere, everything. He sees from everything. It's His own creation. He sees everything. He knows everything. Sometimes He says, when you are about to pray, I already know what you're going to say.
Please.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said to Moses when he was complaining, and he said, Moses, I heard you long time ago. I heard you. Remember when John the Baptist, Zachariah, the father, remember Zachariah? He prayed so many times, said, God, I need a son, when he was still young, when he was still youth. But God answered the prayer, but he didn't see the time. Hallelujah. And then Zachariah was complaining, but still he was serving God. And when the angel came and said, Zachariah, God heard your prayer. By the time he was not praying, why? The Bible says, why? Because he said, I'm already old and my wife is of age. And how will it be? How will I know that I will have a son? The angel said, I will just close your sound. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Can you see that the situation that we are in sometimes they preserve for a better solution? Zachariah, John the Baptist. Jesus says to all those who are born of a woman, John is the greatest. But you today, you are sitting here. John opened the door for you. You are greater than him. You are greater than John. Are you greater than John? Hallelujah. God says that. Jesus says that the least in the kingdom of God is greater than John. The least, someone that he doesn't even pray, but he's in the kingdom of God, is greater than John. Hallelujah. Do we understand ourselves? Do we know who we are? Praise Master Jesus. Because deliverance and everything start in the mind. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have 1,000 rands or 1,000,000 rands, but you don't know that you have in an account, if you don't know, your mind doesn't know, and you don't have food, you still complain that you don't have food, but you don't know. But someone reveals, oh no, but you have inherited from your great father. Just go to the bank. By just knowing you are free, am I right? By just knowing you are free, deliverance is from the mind. That's the reason John says, repent, meaning change the way you think now, because now the kingdom is here. The kingdom is, he was saying that the kingdom is no more with the Romans, but now the kingdom is in you. The kingdom is no more now with the ANC, now the kingdom is in you, the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Are we in the kingdom? Are we the part of the kingdom? Are we part of the kingdom?
Yes.
Hallelujah. The kingdom of God is not only for God, but it's for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Until we take it that we are partner with God, until we take that we are partner with God, in his kingdom, we are partner. It's not all up to God, and it's not all up to you. It takes me and God. It takes you and God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen.
Do you love Jesus?
Love
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy,
oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Locate me.
Locate me.
Locate me.
Locate me.
Contact me.
Contact me.
Contact me.
Contact me.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Contact me.
Contact me.
Locate me.
Locate me.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Act in me.
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 Work in me.
Work in me.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Take more of me.
Take more of me.
And give me more of you.
And give me more of you.
Take more of my sinful nature. And give me more of your righteousness.
Take more of my hatred.
And give me more of your love.
Take more
of my hatred.
And give me more
of your love.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Oh Holy Spirit.
Take more
of my unforgiveness.
And give me more
of your forgiveness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. So we need the Holy Spirit to take over us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are made to be like Jesus. Thou is not that fast. Amen. We are made to be like Jesus, but even thou is not that fast, but we are going there with the Holy Spirit helping us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
That's why now walking on water is just something like a history to us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You should be walking on air now.
Praise,
praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
You should be walking through the walls now. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You shouldn't be worried about someone who says that he has changed petrol, become the apple juice. You shouldn't be worried about those things. You should be doing so many things. You should be building a house without laboring. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. This is the kingdom of God. Of power. Not talking. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Authority and power. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Let me finish by this one. But we don't finish because we are bottomless. Hallelujah.
Yes.
We are bottomless.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You are bottomless. Amen.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This book here, or the Holy Bible here, is nothing to us. Amen. I mean, like, it's so small to us. It's a drop in an ocean. Because I am the presence of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me finish by this one. Do you know that you have authority here on earth? Do you know? Everyone knows. You have authority. Not to the kingdom, not to the government, democracy. I'm not talking about ANC, South African government. You see, you have also, but it's just some of the things you don't know. Hallelujah. If you learn the rights that you have in democracy, you will know that you have much in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. God will not do anything without you here on earth. Do you know that? Do you know that? God, if you just want to stop God, stop connecting to God, God is not going to do anything. We'll continue suffering. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Tell me where in your Bible, where God was just doing things without man. God loves so much man, and then he gave the man authority here on earth. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is not allowed here on earth without you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
There's a reason why God came through Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He wouldn't do that if he wanted to. He's God. He can just say, whatever Adam did, let me just continue because I'm God. He don't have to suffer on the cross. For what good reason? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
God will never do anything here on earth without you. So he need your body to be righteous, to be healed. That's the reason God is healing you. It's not for anything, not for you. For him to do something here on earth. That's the reason God heals you. So next time when you pray, say, God, don't say, God heal me because I want to be healthy. No. God, you're dependent on this body to change anything here on earth. So be healed. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Are we still there? Are we still there? So this is a call for prayer. To always ask God, God, what do you want to do here on earth? I'm here, I'm ready. Amen. Why do you think that God have this kind of people? They say, he says he's a man of God. He's a woman of God. Why do you think God can do that? It's not because they are so special. No, it's not because they are so special. They are the same as you. God loves you as much as he loves any of his apostles. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So when you are ready, God said, okay, let me come in. When you are ready, let me come in. You ask God. That's what God says, that ask me. Pray in his will. Ask in his will. Say, God, what do you want to do here on earth? Because I don't know. Amen. I don't know. But you know, I'm ready. That's the reason God says that the harvest is ready. Ask the master, the owner of the laborer, to release. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. The harvest is ready. The harvest is ready. So many people want to know God. So many people want to know God. But because the laborer are not there, you are not there. That's the reason your brother, your sister, your husband, your wife, whatever, they don't even want to know anything about this Jesus. Hallelujah. That's why they compete Jesus with Muhammad or whoever. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise Mother Jesus. Hallelujah. That one thing for sure, we know that we are not in a religion, we are in a relationship with God. Anyone who is in Christian religion, you are in a wrong place. Hallelujah. We are in a relationship with God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Because religion, we believe something or someone that has died. Something that has happened a long time ago. If you walk in your room and at the corner you feel when you pray, there's an atmosphere, a better atmosphere in that corner. And every time when you wake up and say, let me go to that corner and let me pray there because it's like there's a presence of God there. That's religion. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. God is not outside, he's in you. Hallelujah. Jesus that you pray to, he is in you. Gazing up to the sky, he's just a norm. He is in you. Jesus is in you. Is Jesus here? Is he in you? He is in you. Holy Spirit, as much as the Holy Spirit is in you, Jesus God is in you. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. Do you love Jesus? Do you love Jesus? Hallelujah. So that's what I was giving, is a call for prayer to always ask God. God, what do you want to do? I'm ready. I'm ready. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you're not the servant of God. You are the citizen of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. You are the prince. You walk like you know where you're going and what to do. Hallelujah. And God says that he wants your heart to be like those ones of the children. You know the children, when you're going somewhere, maybe in a car or wherever, they will always ask you, Mama, where are we going? When are we going to do this? They will ask always there. Am I right? Hallelujah. And God says he wants you to be like those hearts. When you always ask God, God, what do you want me to do here on earth? Not you taking God and driving God, conducting God. Hallelujah.